Hello guys, welcome to my tutorial for today. Welcome to my channel and welcome to my video at Trust Stitches. In this tutorial, I will teach you guys how to make this boo-boo butterfly gown to easily rock your jean trouser or your skirt trouser. I can see how it is, how the rope is where I pass my rope. If you really want to watch this video today, I want you to stay tuned and kindly click on the subscribe button and click on the notification bell to notify you once I drop a new video. Welcome back guys. Today's tutorial, I will teach you how to draft and sew boo-boo butterfly top, that is with rope at the front. Mazi boo-boo for your top is easily to rock on your jean and on your skirt. In this tutorial, I will teach you how to make that boo-boo, how to cut it, how to draft it, how to sew it for your parties. Now, I'm just using this just 1 yard and 15 inches of fabric, not up to half. Now, I'm going to fold it like this. Before I start, kindly click on the subscribe button for me and click on that notification bell to notify you once I drop a new video. Before I start, the top I will be working on of top of length of 24, top length of 24. Then the wideness should be sort of like 44. That is how you want the wideness to be, because I'm still going to use my rope to tie it to make that fitting for me. Now I'm going to use half length of 16, because that half length is where I'm going to make the rope to pass through. Then I need my half length. Now let's go for the tutorial on how to make it. Now I'm going to fold this fabric like this into two, like so. You can see how it is. Now I'm going to fold it like this just to make the top. Then after folding it, then I'll go ahead and just a little bit make it neater. Then after that, I'm going to close it like this. You can see how I did that, how I close it. And I'll close it just to make a shape. You can see it's folded into four, that is both front and back of what I need. And I'm going to do it like this, make it straight a little bit. Now you can see, now let's check what you have. You are working on length of 24. Right here I'm having 25 inches. That is the 1 inches with sort of maybe you want to weave it, or you are going to fold it at the down. Now you can see I don't have any joining here, it's closed. Maybe you are not with enough fabric. You have a joining here, and that doesn't mean that you still get the style. But for this, because I have enough fabric, there's no open at this top. So you can open your own, that's how your fabric is. Now, like this, let's check what we have. Now, depending on how you measure your back, because for this back is full back, that is your back including your sleeve joined together. Now, if you want to measure the back, you're going to place the staple at the middle of the back like this. Then you measure it all the way to where you want it to stop at your sleeve. You can go ahead and stop at maybe your back is 7, then you continue measuring it. Maybe you want this to stop at 18, or you want it to stop at, maybe you don't want the boo-boo to be much bold, to be much wide. Then you can stop after your back, then you can stop at where you want. That is how you want it. If you want it at the wrist, you can go ahead and measure all the way from the back to the sleeve. That is the half, you start from half of your back, not your full back. From half of your back, then you measure it all the way to the sleeve. Now, let's go on how to do that. Now, let's check what I have right here. Know it, you can see how I fold it. If you have enough fabric, if I measure what I have here, it's not up to my wrist, that it may be somewhere around here or around, there's no up to here. But if you want your own to be full to your sleeve, you can go ahead and make the fabric enough for you. That is how boo-boo you want. But now let's check what I have. Now I'm having then, maybe this is my back is 7.5. this is 7.5 right there. Then let's check what you have. You can see I'm left with 15 inches. That 15 inches with sort of, I'm going to, it's sort of like this at this side. From if I wear this boo-boo, this is where I'm going to stop, because this is where the fabric is right there. So if you want your hole, then you can make the fabric enough for you for yourself. That I just quickly explain that for you guys to see. Now let's go for the what we have. After this, we are going to cut the neck. That is how neck you want it to be. Now, if I check what I have, I said the wideness, I want the wideness of 24. The wideness of 44, which is 11 inches. Now, 11 inches will be my wideness. Now, you can see where it is, 11 inches. Then, I'm going to go for my armhole. How do you get your armhole? You are going to start the armhole measurement from where I stop here. You can see right here, this 11. Then, also at this hop, I'm going to, this 12, then at this hop, I'm going to get sort of like 12 inches. You can see sort of like 11 inches. Now this is 11 inches, then 11 inches, you can see right here, then another 11 inches. Now this 11 inches will be my wideness. Then the wideness, you're going to start from the up to check the wideness. Now you are going with armhole. I want the armhole off because it's sort of like no zip at the back. Then I have the armhole to be wide. And I'll go with armhole of 10 inches. You can see my armhole is 10 inches. Then I'm going to join it from this 10 inches all the way down. You can see. Then you go ahead and chalk it again. This is 11 inches. Then you chalk. You chalk the 11 inches. Just to get where you are going to place your, and then you chalk it all the way down. Now I've chalked this 11 inches. Now I'm going to sew it from this point all the way to this down. From this point all the way to this down. You can see what I just did there. I started my wideness at this 11 inches. Just the reason why I started the wideness is sort of to get the armhole where I'm going to start my armhole. Then my armhole is going to start here, which is 11 inches all the way. Then I'm going to sew it from this side all the way to this side. Then after that, let's go for the cuffing, because sort of I don't want it straight at this side. You can see the down is sort of straight and it's sort of those holding tight sets. So I want it sexy, then slant at this sort of TM cuff. Now how do you cuff it? I'm going to cuff it by 4 inches. Then I cuff it right here, you can see. Then from this side, you are going to cuff it like this. You can see what I did. Then you cuff it. That's how cuff you. If you want the cuff to be up, you can go again and cuff it right there. And if you want the cuff to be sort of not that cuff, then I'm going to cuff it. Then I use 4 inches for the cuffing. Then you cuff it. You can make it above it, or maybe you want it 6 inches or 7 inches. But for my own, I want the cuffing to be like this. Now let's cut out the cuffing. I'm going to cut out the cuffing like this. All the way to this down. You can see how sexy it is, how it is. Now after the cuffing, you can see what I have. I'm going to join it from this point all the way to the down. Now how do you go about this? Now let's cut out the neck. I'm going to cut out the neck. That is any neck style you want it. Now for my neck style, I don't want the neck style to be that wide. Then I'm going to use 4 inches for my neck style. That is 4 inches width. Then I'm going to use depth of 5 inches, because I don't want the neck to be that lower. The depth of 5 inches. Then go ahead and cuff it with your free hand, or use your French cuff to cuff it out. You can see it's so easy and fast to cuff. That is how you want it. If you want the neck to be sort of like V-neck, you can cut it V-neck. If you want it to sort of like kissing neck, you can cut it, or asymmetric neck. But for this tutorial, I'm cutting out round neck for this. Then next tip I want to give you is that you won't get confused when sewing it. You have to notch all this side. Then I'm going to notch it at the neck, just to know where it is, so just to make it equal. Then I'm going to notch it at this point also. Then I notch it at this side. Then I notch it at this side. Then after I notch it, then I'll go right now to sew it. Then I want to give you a tip at this down quickly. If you want to sew it, you can go ahead and turn it first at this down. After turning it, then you join. Because when joining without turning it, if you go ahead and join it, it will be more difficult for you to turn because of the curve that we have. It's even preferable you weave it. But for this story, I'm going to turn it just to make it fast. Then I'm going to fold it inside. Then make sure you fold all the down before making it. Then after that, then you fold it like this all the way, including the hand. You are going to fold it here, or you weave it to this side. All the rough edges will be weave or will be folding. Now let me go quickly and show you guys before. Then before I go, I'm going to cut where. Let's go for the rope hole. How do you cut your rope hole? Your rope hole determine your waist. Now if you are using waist of 44, you are going to cut the rope hole at this 44. But for this tutorial, I will be using waist of 15 inches for my rope hole. Now I'm going to use 15 inches for the rope hole. Then I will just make a dot like this. Now before you cut it, you have to look at your wideness. Remember, I'm going to join it all the way from this side to this down. Then I'm going to leave like 1 inch space, so that when turning it, it won't affect the joining I'm going to join. Then I see I'm left with, I just leave 1 inch space between the joining, there is the joining and the rope hole space. Now do you cut your rope hole? At this 15 inches that I came down by 15 inches, I'm going up by 1 inches. Then I go down by 1/2 inches. I go up by 1 inches, then I come down by 1/2 inches, making 1.5. Now I'm going to make a straight line to join them together. Now I'm going to cut it here. How do you cut it? If you don't have a blade, that is a sharp object to cut it, you can just raise up your fabric like this. Then you go ahead and make just a tiny space, just a tiny. Then you cut it tiny. You can cut it like this. You can see how tiny I did, how tiny I cut it out. Then you cut it and check what you have. That you have it deep. You can see it's sort of like deep, like this. But they are not cut, not that cut to the egg that I want. Both are all closed. Then I'm going to raise it up again. Then you raise it up like this. Then you cut it sort of like just not that much and not that wide for you to sew. Now, because when turning it, I'm going to have a large hole at that point. Now I've got what I want. Then I'm going to trim it, just straight it. Now you can see what I have. The rope hole is sort of like open that I want. Now I'm going to my machine now to sew it, the rope hole. I'm going to use my bias tape to sew it inside. Then you join it from this point all the way down. Then remember what I just said, that before joining, make sure you cut all the rough edges. I'm going to fold all the rough edges, starting from this point all the way down. After folding it, then you go for your neck, your joining, then the rope hole. Now let me quickly cut the rope. I've cut out the rope that I want to. This is the rope that I'm using. It's sort of like 2 inches rope hole. You can see, and it's long. That is long as you want. If you want it longer, you can go for it. This is what I just made. Then I'm going to sew the rope. I'm going to sew the rope just 1/2 inches sewing. After sewing, then I'll turn it out and show you guys. I'm going to do that. Remember to turn all your rough edges. Now I'm coming back for you guys to see. Hello guys, after sewing it, this is what I have. This is what I got. You can see how it is, how sexy and fast it is. You can see it's easy to rock on your jean, rock on your trouser or your skirt. You can see how I tied the bow, sort of like bow rope. You can see, just to make it, I want you guys to know how to tie this bow rope so that it will be fitted and fine. You can see the neck. I go for a various neck you want. Maybe it's for V-neck, asymmetric neck, or any kind of neck that you want. It's just few fabric of Ankara, and I got this and I made it. You can see how it is, how the sleeve is. Now I want to quickly tell you guys for one thing. Remember to add your folding allowance at this end, just like 1/2 inches. You can see that I just fold it on my machine just to make it fast. You can decide to go for whipping. You can see how the TM curve and how mazzy it is. Now if you want it more mazzy, you can go ahead and use widener that is mazzy. Now just use 44 inches wideness. You can see the sleeve, the heart, and sort of like butterfly. After wearing it, you can see how it is, how rocking it is with the neck. Thanks for watching this video. Thanks for watching my boo-boo butterfly gown video. Thanks so much. Kindly click on that subscribe button and click on the notification bell to notify me once I drop a video. And if you use any of my video for yourself or for your fabric, kindly notify me so that I can see how my videos goes. Thanks for watching this video. Thanks so much. Thanks. Bye.